Good afternoon. This is the eve of the Super Bowl. These are my Super Bowl gambling bets, because remember, it's more than just a game. It's can you cover the spread? Like and subscribe, hate and comment. And of course, because the government doesn't let you be adults, this is for entertainment purposes only. Yep, we're still there. Stupid state court. One day we'll be able to be real people. Alrighty, so as you know, there are a number of Super Bowl bets that can be made. Not just on the game, not just on the over-under, but really stupid stuff. I'm going to go over all the important stupid stuff you need to know. And things you don't. First thing is, we got to kick it off with the national anthem. Yay, USA, USA. And it's some guy named Chris Stapleton. He's a country singer, so under. Now, depending on your jurisdiction, and who sets the bet, I got two different answers for you. So if you're going simply by his singing, I've seen, certain ones at, 1 minute and 42 seconds, I would take the under. If you're going the entire length of the song, I would still take the under. It's 119 and a half seconds. Country singer, always going to take the under. That's my rule. It may be bad. Probably will be. Now, will he omit a word? Probably. It pays really crappy though. $3,030 to make $100. I probably wouldn't waste my money on it. Now on to more important things, like the color of Gatorade. It's gonna be this color shirt, baby, blue. By the way, there have been years where there have been no coaches getting dunked by beautiful Gatorade. Actually, Bill Belichick. Giants fame? I know. You think Patriots, but yeah, started with the Giants with that whole thing many, many moons ago. He's actually avoided it 3 times. Now, of course, he will not be avoiding it because he's not there, so I guess technically he is avoiding it. But it will be blue, and it will happen. Now, how to make some cheddar on that bet. You're going to take an offense and defensive player to actually do the dunking. That pays about $400 on a $100 bet. Now, first touchdown. Without really revealing who I think is going to win the game, I'm going to go with Jalen Hurts. Now, is that a sign I'm going to pick the Eagles? Possibly. Wait for the end of the video. But I actually think Jalen Hurts is going to have a rushing touchdown, depending on which book you are looking at. Of course, for entertainment purposes only, you're looking at about 7-1 odds. But I do think it will be a short run by him. If you do want to balance it out and take a chief, I will look at Kelsey. I'm also taking, first touchdown is looking right now about 700-1. Now, multiple touchdowns for Kelsey. I have, which, you know, be two or more. I would also take that with some pretty good odds. And for the MVP, we'll get to that in a little bit, but I'm going to give you a couple different options. I think you should hedge your bets with the three I'm going to come up with. So the halftime show is Rihanna. Now the over-under on songs is 8.5, and depending on your jurisdiction, and by the time you see this video, it's possible that the set list could already be out. So many betting houses will put things, once it becomes public knowledge, you can't bet on it. One of them is a guest who will be singing with Rihanna. Allegedly, this is public knowledge, Bruno Mars. I don't know how it is, but when I went to look at a sporting site, you said you could not bet on Bruno Mars as being a guest singer. If it's not true, then the gambling houses are being weird. There is odds on Eminem. They're still out there. I think I would take that bet. Remember, that's all right. I like the way it burns. Would give her time to do a, outfit change. Now the over under on songs is 8.5. You may think that it seems pretty low, but remember Prince only did like 6. The Who did 5. Most people aren't Justin Timberlake and have like 1,000 songs in their category. So I'm going to take the under on the 8.5. I think it's probably gonna be closer to 8. Now, for the first song, here's the thing. It's been, I think, almost 7 years since she's been on the stage. So I don't think it's going to be Umbrella. It's only going to be Where Have You Been, which pays 3-1. But what I think it's going to be is What's My Name, which pays 5-1 on most of the books. I think you could make a little money by stating that she's going to fall. So, there's some houses out of England. It pays 15-1 that she takes a little tumble. Not falling on her butt, but like literally like a trip. That would give you 1,500 smackers on a $100 bet. So I'm not sure. Possibly I would take that bet because I did. Maybe. Again, entertainment purposes only. As for the rest of the game, your MVP is going to be Patrick Mahomes. You may want to hedge it. So if you're going to make maybe a third of the bet with Kelsey, depending on the book, it's between 8-14-1. If you want to hedge your bet, if you thought the Eagles are going to win, I don't think they are. You could put a couple dollars on Jalen Hurts. I'm going to take the over. My exact score, by the way, this would be an outright bet because technically Kansas City is a 1.5 favorite. So I just take the money line. It's a little bit more. I'm going to say Kansas City is going to score 34 and Eagles are going to score 22. I'm going to give you that odd number because they're going to try to get back and they're going to miss a 2-point conversion. So let's see what happens. See if my gambling prowess is there. And, well, if not, again, entertainment purposes only. If you did want to do a hedge on the first touchdown, by the way, you may want to look at Dallas Gabbert. I also think Dallas Gabbert paying 12-1 will have the longest touchdown of the game. I don't have any money on it, but again, entertainment purposes only. But you may want to look at that. So, like and subscribe, hit and comment. See you at the Super Bowl tomorrow.